because these items are much more expensive over there, so they buy them here in bulk.
Brazilian visitors to New York City have increased over 500% since 2005, with more than 800,000 coming here in 2012, third behind the UK and Canada. They spent $2.4 billion in 2012. In that category, they take first place. Inflation and high sales taxes in Brazil are part of what's making New York City relatively cheap and therefore popular. Plus, of course, many Brazilians just have more money these days. Worst says that his hotel, where rooms start at over $500 a night and go swiftly upward, started to see Brazilians hosting destination events there.
We see a lot of private parties. They bring their own designers that create theme parties. We've had like a New Year's Eve party up in our penthouse where basically 10 people spend $15,000.
The Brazilians are the ones that throw a party. I have never seen parties like the ones that are shown here.
João Coelho and his wife, Clarissa Resende, designed that 15 grand New Year's Eve party, which came complete with a Frank Sinatra impersonator, a makeup bar, and antique clocks for each guest that sounded at midnight.
The makeup bar was a huge success. The Frank Sinatra cover was also unexpected by the guests, and the ugly walk-in, the guy was already singing. Everybody loved it.
Put on a destination Baby It's Cold Outside wintertime brunch, ice skates and jars of maple syrup among the party favors, and a Lion King themed day in New York City. Coelho and his wife just got into designing destination events a year ago, but say it now accounts for 30 or 40% of their business. Another high-end Sao Paulo travel agent told me that he's regularly called on to book VIP rooms in top-tier restaurants and clubs, and private tours of museums. Recently he ran down last-minute tickets for a Sting show. He says his most challenging assignment was renting out an entire hotel. He'd rather not say which one. Advertisements to New York City make it to Brazilian TV.